Well, and joining us from Washington is Congressman Adam Schiff, ranking Democrat on the House Intelligence Committee. He represents Burbank, Glendale, and Pasadena. Congressman, on Friday, the Attorney General announced the indictment of 12 Russians, members of the U.S., or excuse me, the Russian military, for hacking into the 2016 campaign for president, the Democratic National Committee computers, as well as those of some state election offices. What's your reaction?
Well, this was not unexpected. When the special counsel sought the indictment earlier of the Russians that were involved in the troll farm and the surreptitious social media campaign, it begged the question about what about the hacking and dumping operation? When will that be the subject of indictment? And the answer is now. That indictment has been returned. There's still an open question, of course, about whether there are more charges to come involving U.S. persons. This particular indictment doesn't involve U.S. persons, but of course it doesn't exclude the possibility that special counsel will later seek charges against any Americans that might have been involved in facilitating this hacking and dumping release of documents. The timing of it, the coordination of it, as we know, the Russians had informed the campaign through Papadopoulos and maybe others that they were in possession of these stolen materials.
Well, the president talks face-to-face with Vladimir Putin on Monday. You went to the well of the floor of the House of Representatives to say that, as far as you're concerned, the president of the United States is more comfortable with autocrats and dictators than he is with democracy. Here's what you had to say.
Where when you look around the world, you must conclude objectively that the autocrats are on the rise. In places like Poland and in Hungary, in the rise of the far-right parties in Germany, in Austria, in France, with Erdogan in Turkey. Turkey is now the leading jailer of journalists in the world. In the Philippines with Duterte. People all over the world, they look to us. They're not going to look to Russia. They're not going to look to China. They're not going to look to Europe with all its problems. And increasingly, they do not recognize what they see. America is not sleeping, but one of its great parties is. As John Boehner said recently, the Republican Party is off taking a nap somewhere. Wake up.
Why did you make that speech?
Well, it's part of a couple speeches I've given now that are a cry to wake up the Republican Party, which is, as John Boehner said recently, off sleeping somewhere. We need really both parties to confront what this president is doing. And what I said on the House floor would be later borne out all too well by the president's trip to Europe, where he bashed Germany, where he bashed our British allies, where he interfered with their domestic politics. This is, I think, just wreaking destruction on our collective security, and we need to speak out about it. He's clearly, our president, not comfortable with the Democratic leader of Britain, with the Democratic leader of Canada, with the Democratic leader of Germany, with the Democratic leader of Australia, with any number of Democratic leaders around the world. But he appears very comfortable with Vladimir Putin, with Kim Jong-un even, with people like Erdogan who are becoming increasingly dictatorial. And Americans need to wake up, and in particular, given that the Republicans, at least for the moment, are running the Congress, they specifically need to wake up.
Getting back to Rod Rosenstein, the Attorney General's news conference on Friday, he specifically said that this is a nonpartisan issue, this is a bipartisan issue.
You went on CNN recently and said that Republican Congressman Trey Gowdy, the chair of the House Oversight Committee,
was one of those individuals from the Republican side who prostrates themselves in front of the president and gives him whatever he wants. Mr. Gowdy responded on Fox News with this.
He wanted to be the attorney general under Hillary Clinton, and no one in the country worked harder to protect her than Adam Schiff. He wanted to be the head of the CIA. He wanted to run for California and run for Senate in the People's Republic of California, but he couldn't win either of those seats. I want you to go back, Jason, and think of all the things you would not know if you had taken Adam Schiff's advice. You wouldn't know the spontaneous reaction to a video was a hoax. In Libya, you would never have read the first Chris Stevens email. You wouldn't know that Hillary Clinton had this unique email arrangement with herself because Adam Schiff did everything in his power to keep you from finding out. You wouldn't know about the dossier. You wouldn't know who funded it. You wouldn't know it was used in a court proceeding. You wouldn't know about Strzok and Page. Look, if they secede from the union and President Maxine Waters wants to make him the attorney, General in California, more power to him. Otherwise, I don't think anybody on my side of the aisle gives much of a damn what Adam Schiff thinks.
Respond to that.
Well, the problem with Mr. Gowdy's argument is that I participated in a bipartisan investigation involving the Clinton administration, involving Benghazi, and we reached a bipartisan conclusion. That was not Trey Gowdy's committee, though. It was the House Intelligence Committee, led by a different Republican, Mike Rogers, and we were able to work well and reach a common conclusion. The problem is, I think, with Mr. Gowdy, that his interest is in defending the president alone. His interest in the last administration was attacking Hillary Clinton alone. And that is, I think, transparently the kind of political and partisan attitude to the nation's security that Rod Rosenstein was condemning. That is the problem. And it certainly has to be addressed. I'll say one other thing about Rod Rosenstein's comments in terms of the impact on the elections. We can expect to see the president misrepresent what Rod Rosenstein just said. Rod Rosenstein said that it's beyond their purview to determine how much the Russians succeeded, that is, how many votes may they have influenced. All he can say is that they haven't found evidence that the machines that were counting the votes were interfered with in the vote count. But we can wait and practically count down the moments until the president misrepresents that as saying that somehow the Justice Department has found that the Russian meddling had no influence on the outcome.
And last question, let's move to politics a little bit. A colleague of yours, Congresswoman Linda Sanchez from Orange County, a fifth-ranking member, vice chair of the Democratic Conference in the House, she said it's about time that the leadership of the party in the House of Representatives move aside, that Nancy Pelosi at 78, 79 years old, you have some of her lieutenants as well in their late 70s, that it's about time for some of the leadership in their 70s to move aside and let some of the young Democrats, the members that are slowly making their way up into the party, have some control of the minority and possibly a majority in the House after the election. What is your reaction to that? Should indeed Nancy Pelosi, Steny Hoyer, and others move aside and let some of the new blood from the Democratic Party lead the party going into the next year?
Well, you know, I will say this. There are a lot of us that have been brought into the leadership, myself included. And one of the things that Leader Pelosi did is she made me the ranking Democrat on the Intelligence Committee when I was not the most senior or the second most senior or even the third most senior. So she has sought to cultivate a new generation of leadership for the House. What I'm waiting for and what I'm looking for is to see, is anyone out there working as hard as Nancy Pelosi to take back the House right now? And the answer is no. No one is working as hard as she is. And I think no one is good as a strategist as she is. So I'm hoping that we will win the House back and that she'll be our next speaker. I also expect that there are going to be new people in the leadership, and I think that's appropriately so. But before we cast aspersions on our current leadership, I challenge anyone to work as hard as Leader Pelosi is right now to take back the House of Representatives.
Congressman Adam Schiff, ranking Democrat, House Intelligence from Burbank, Glendale, Pasadena. Congressman, thanks for taking the time.
My pleasure. Thank you.